begin with. About three straight sessions of negative movements, if you like. Good to see us back in the green.
The last three sessions, what we've seen is the material sector, the energy and the industrial sectors being hit pretty hard. In fact, the 3 days of losses has seen the material sector down by about 5%, the energy sector down by 3.7%, and the industrial sector down by 3.5%. So not surprising to see these three sectors the strongest performing today. Jumping back, we saw the material space up by 0.8%. The energy space was a standout, up by 1.7% after oil prices came back overnight. And we also saw the industrial sector up by 1.5%. Of course, the market focusing in on offshore markets, and the Wall Street Journal talking about new quantitative easing, or a new form of quantitative easing in the form of long-dated bond buying. So that really gave overseas offshore markets a boost. And of course, some chatter about the reserve requirement ratio in China perhaps coming down. Inflation's going to be an important read from China tomorrow, where we are expecting to see the inflation number coming down from 4.5% down to 3.4%, and that's going to be an important factor in what the market thinks is going to happen with the reserve requirement ratio or interest rates in China. But altogether, a good day by the Australian share market. You can see that we did see a strong day of gains. One other stock which is worth a mention is Echo Entertainment. It does look like Crown's lifted its stake from 9.2% up to 10%. And if we have a look at the last 30 days in Echo Entertainment, this is what it looks like. And you can see just the type of impact a big company like Crown buying into its share register has, and we've seen the shares up by 17% over the last 1 month.
I just want to go back to something you mentioned before, in particular the rumor swirling for a lot of the afternoon session today about China potentially cutting the reserve ratio requirements. I mean, how much chance, likelihood do you think there is in that? I mean, from my sort of thinking, there's plenty of liquidity floating around the system, maybe means that they might not go, but it certainly was a rumor that wouldn't go away.
It did have an impact in terms of the market too. If we have a look at the Australian share market, we didn't see much of an impact. We did see a bit of an uptick on the close, but what we did see in terms of the Aussie dollar was quite a strong move. Now, this is actually the two-day chart for the Aussie dollar, but if I just change that to a one-day view, this is what it looks like. And you can see the last couple of hours just what the Aussie dollar has done. Now, you would expect the Aussie dollar on a day like this to be showing weakness. Yesterday, we had the weak GDP read for the fourth quarter. Today, we've got a weak jobs number coming out for the month of February, and yet the Aussie dollar, after that initial impact of the jobs, has just seen a gain straight up. So a bit of speculation around the China reserve requirement ratio. Of course, one of the key things driving that is the weakness that we are seeing in terms of China, in terms of the property market. But this week's been a massive week from China. We've seen that 8% forecast being cut down to 7.5%, and of course the world just adjusting its expectations from China.
Issues. I wanted to get your thoughts, or just maybe paint the picture of the reaction on markets, in particular, I suppose, the Aussie dollar, when we did in fact get that jobs print out.
Well, the Aussie dollar had a sharp drop on the back of those job numbers, and I guess expectations of an interest rate cut has increased on the back of not only just the employment numbers coming out, which are quite volatile, but that's on top of the softer GDP read, as Francesco mentioned yesterday. So altogether, those expectations did see quite a sharp reaction in the Aussie dollar. So if I bring up that chart again, you can see exactly what happened at 11:30 a.m. But you can see the afternoon has been a very bullish picture for the Aussie dollar. Of course, tonight is going to be important because all eyes will be on that Greek restructure deal. The deal expires at 9 p.m. Central European time, and that translates to 7 a.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. So we'll be watching that very closely, but the results probably won't be out straight away. Three key scenarios here: that we do see 95% of the private bondholders agreeing to the deal, or more than 95%. That would be the ideal outcome. But even if we see more than two-thirds agreeing, then we will see the collective agreement clause being put into play. And I guess the people that don't agree, they'll be bound by the haircut on this Greek debt. The worst case scenario is if we see less than two-thirds of the private bondholders agree, and that would mean no bailout funds, no second bailout funds from Europe, and a disorderly default potentially because of that 20th of March payment of 14.4 billion euros, which is due up for maturity. So all eyes on Greece tonight, and I guess we'll find out tomorrow morning or in the next couple of days.